everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video I'm going to discuss about pollen grains. So I'll be discussing introduction, structure of pollen grain, application in forensic science, pollen DNA barcoding and the drawbacks of pollen grain. So first, introduction. There's a term called palynology. Palynology means study of pollen grains. Then comes forensic palynology. So forensic palynology is the application of palynology, that is the study of pollen grain, into forensic science. So in easy terms we can say that when pollen grains are used to solve crime, then that is called forensic palynology. Alright, so pollen can be defined as a fine yellowish color powder, as you can see here in the picture also. All over the bee is a fine yellow powder, that is pollen grain. Now pollen grain is so tiny, so small, that if a group of pollen grains are together, then that is going to act like powder. Alright, then pollen is a male gametophyte, so pollen needs to go and attach itself on the female gametophyte. So for that it has various transporting methods, like for example it can be transported by wind, by bird, by insect or by other animals. So if it is transferred by wind, it is called anemophily. If by water, it's called hydrophily. If by insect, it's called entomophily. So there are different terms for that. Now during this transportation, there is a possibility that the pollen might get transferred onto the body of the suspect also. So that's how pollen can help us in solving criminal cases as well. How? Let's learn that now. First, let's understand the structure of pollen grain, because that is important. There are two main layers, exine and intine. Exine, as you can see here, exine is the outermost layer and it has tiny spikes over it. So these helps in the attachment to various surfaces. These spikes also might help on attaching to the body of the suspect, like over the clothes or on the hair or on the footwear. So the pollen might get attached to the body of the suspect with the help of these small spikes. Also, the exine is made up of a very resistant material which is known as sporopollenin, and this sporopollenin protects it from all kinds of chemicals. So it becomes very difficult for these pollen grains to get destructed in any way. If we talk about the forensic importance, then for pollen grain acts as a corroborative evidence. Corroborative evidence means that it helps in supporting an already present evidence. Alright, that means that it is an additional evidence which is going to connect the accused to the crime. Already there's a evidence present, already we are very much sure that this person might be the culprit. So a pollen grain can help us to additionally support that yes, this person is the culprit. If a suspect was present at a particular crime scene at which pollen can be found, like for example there is a plant that is found at only a particular area, then if the suspect was present at that area, they might have picked up some pollen grain on their clothing. So because the pollen grain is so resilient, it can often stick to the other object. As I have told, it has spikes. Even after the object has been washed, it's very difficult to remove it completely because it is so small that it can fix itself into little spores also. So pollen can reveal where a person or an object has been, because regions of the world, countries and even different parts of the garden have different pollen. Now there are different types of plants all over the world, and these plants are going to have their own pollen grains. Pollen grains are going to have different shapes and sizes. So depending on that, we can pollen grains can help us know where a person has been or an object has been. So that's how pollen can help us tell that the person has been to this place and then there is a possibility that there might be pollen found on the cloth of the person and also on the cloth of the suspect and also on the crime scene. Okay, so that can also help us establish that yes, this person, this suspect was present on that crime scene, and hence there is a very high chance that that person is the culprit. So there's what happens after that is that the pollen are so tiny that they need to be looked under a microscope in order to reveal the structure, but sometimes that also does not work. So what we do then is pollen DNA barcoding. In this we identify the plant species to which the pollen belong to by amplifying and sequencing the particular regions of the pollen DNA. Being able to accurately identify pollen has a wide range of application, but there's a problem also since the data bank information, there's no adequate data bank information for all these pollen grains. So there are other drawbacks too, like for example, it lacks complete information. It is not going to give us complete information about the case. It is just a corroborative evidence. Also, the location that we are going to know, we cannot be 100% sure about that, because that kind of plant can also be present at certain other location also. So we cannot be 100% sure. And also the techniques to collect the sample necessary to conduct investigation are not that proper. People generally, investigating officers, do not even consider pollen as a very important evidence at the time of solving the crime scene. So these were the drawbacks. So this was all about the video. Thank you for watching it till the end. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel.